Okay, good morning children. Today we are going to do 6th question in page number 7, workbook. So what is given in 6th question? How to show the numbers given in abacus. Show the following numbers on the abacus. So what is the first number? The first number is 6805. Now we have to show 6805 on abacus. For this, let us draw the abacus. Okay. Here I have drawn 4 spikes because this number is starting from 1000's place. Here I have drawn 4 spikes because this number is starting from 1000's place. This is 1's place, 10's place, 100's place, and 1000's place. In 1000's place, we are having 6. So we have to draw 6 beads in 1000's place. Okay. In 100's place, we are having 8. So we have to draw 8 beads in 100's place. Okay. Next, in 10's place, we are having 0, which means no beads. No need of showing any bead in 10's place because it is having 0. Okay. In 1's place, you have to show 5 beads. Because it is given 5 in 1's place, you have to show 5 beads. Okay, did you understand? Here the question is, you have to show the given numbers in abacus. For that, you have to draw the abacus. Here the number is 6805. This number is starting from 1000's place and it is having 4 digits. So you have to draw 4 spikes for the abacus. Okay. So I have drawn 4 spikes and named each spike as 1s, 10s, 100s and 1000s. In 1000s place we are having 6, so I have arranged 6 beads. In 100s place we are having 8, so I have arranged 8 beads. In 10s place we are having 0, so there is no need of showing any beads. In 1s place we are having 5, so I have shown 5 beads. Okay, let us do the piece sum. Okay. In B sum you are given 3007. Here we are having 4 cases. So we have to draw 4 spikes. Okay. 4 spikes. 1 for 1's place, 10's place, 100's place and 1000's place. In 1000's place we are having 3. So we have to arrange 3 beads in 1000's place. Okay. In 100's place, we are having 0. So, there is no need of showing any bead in 100's place. In 10's place also, we are having 0. So, there is no need of showing any bead in 10's place. And in 1's place, we are having 7. So, we have to show 7 beads here. 7 beads. Okay. So, what I have done? The number is 3007. So I have to draw 4 spikes. Since this number is having 4 digits, we have to draw 4 spikes. After drawing 4 spikes, we have to arrange the places. First one is 1s, 10s, and 100s and 1000s. In 1000s place, the number is 3, so I have to draw 3 beads. In 100s place, there is 0, so there is no need of showing any bead here. In 10s place also, it is given 0, so no need of showing any beads here. And in 1's place you are having 7, so you have to show 7 beads. Now let us do the C sum. In C sum it is given 5089. This is also a 4 digit number, so I have to draw 4 spikes. Okay. After drawing the spikes, I have to write the places. So 1's place, 10's place and 100's place and 1000's place. 1's, 10's, 100's, 1000's. In 1000's place we are having 5. So I have to draw 5 beads. In 100's place it is given 0. So there is no need of drawing any bead here. And in 10's place you are having 8. So you have to show 8 beads in 10's place. Okay, in 1's place you are having 9, so you have to show 9 beads. Okay. This is the way to arrange numbers in abacus. I have explained three sums. Remaining three sums you do for homework. So now let us do the seventh sum. Did you understand, children? Here I have done the three sums. Remaining three sums you do for homework. Now let us do the seventh sum. So let us see the seventh sum. Okay, what is the seventh sum? Seventh sum is to compare the following. We have to compare the following numbers. Using the symbol. Using the symbol. Greater than, lesser than, and equal to. So today, seventh question is we have to compare the given numbers with greater than, lesser than, and equal to symbols. So let us do the first sum. What is the first sum? 1524. 1539. Now we have to compare these two numbers. In thousands place, this is a four-digit number and this is also a four-digit number. In thousands place and hundreds place, both the numbers are having same numbers. Here in thousands place we are having one, and here also in thousands place we are having one. In hundreds place we are having five, and in hundreds place here also we are having five. In tens place this number is having two, and this number is having three. Which one is smaller? This one is smaller and this one is bigger. So you have to use the lesser than symbol here. This shows, lesser than symbol shows that the first number is smaller than the second number. What does the lesser than symbol show? Lesser than symbol show that the first number is smaller than the second number. Here 1524 is smaller than 1539. Okay. Now let us do the G sum. In G sum we have given 5548. And 5548. Okay. Both the numbers are having same. Both the numbers are having same digits in all the places. Yes? In thousands place, both the numbers are having five. In hundreds place also, both the numbers are having five. In tens place, both the numbers are having eight. Sorry, four. And in ones place, both the numbers are having eight. So these two numbers are same. So you have to place the symbol equal to. Now let us do the C sum. Okay. 8745. 6507. Now we have to compare these two numbers. Both the numbers are having four digits. In thousands place this number is having 8 and this number is having 6. So which is bigger? 8 is bigger or 6 is bigger? 8 is bigger. So you have to put the symbol greater than. You have to put the symbol greater than. Greater than symbol shows that the first number is bigger than the second number. Greater than symbol shows that the first number is bigger than the second number. Since 8745 is bigger than 6507, we have placed the symbol greater than. Now let us do the D sum. 6843. 6483. See, both the numbers are having same number of digits. Here in thousands place both the numbers are having 6. In hundreds place this number is having 8. And this number is having 4. Which is bigger? 8 is bigger or 4 is bigger? 8 is bigger. So you have to place the symbol greater than, because the first number is bigger than the second number. Okay, now let us do the E sum. 4370 and 4370. Both the numbers are having same digits in all the places. This is also having 4 in thousands place. This is also having 4 in thousands place. This is having 3 in hundreds place. This is also having 3 in hundreds place. Here in tens place, both the numbers are same. In ones place also, both the numbers are same. So you have to put the symbol equal to, because both the numbers are same. Now let us do the epsom. 2020 and 2002. In these numbers also, both the numbers are having 2 in thousands place, 0 in hundreds place. In tens place, we are having 2 here and 0 here. So which is bigger? 2 is bigger or 0 is bigger? 2 is bigger. So you have to put the symbol greater than. You have to put the symbol greater than, because 2020 is greater than 2002. Okay, let us do the G sum. 7669 7820. Here in thousands place, both the numbers are having same digits. In hundreds place, this number is having 6 and this number is having 8. So 6 is smaller than 8, which means the first number is lesser than the second number. Next, H sum. 7240. Here both the numbers are same, so you have to put the symbol equal to. Again I am writing, because you can't see this in the camera, so I am doing this sum again, okay? I am doing this sum again because you can't see it in the camera. 7669, 7820. So in thousands place, both the numbers are having same numbers, same digits. In hundreds place, this number is having 6 and this number is having 8. 6 is smaller than 8, so you have to put the symbol lesser than. Okay, did you understand, students? Okay, let us do the 8th sum. Let us do the 8th sum. Now let us do the 8th sum. 8th sum. All these sums, I put them in the WhatsApp. If you want to check them, you can recheck the sums, okay? Now let us do the 8th sum. Eighth sum is, you have to arrange the following numbers in ascending order and descending order. Now to arrange the given numbers in ascending order and descending order. You all know that ascending order means small to big and descending order means big to small. Today we are going to arrange the numbers from small to big and also from big to small. So let us do the A sum. For today I am explaining only one sum. Remaining sums we are going to do day after tomorrow. So I explain only A sum for today, and the remaining sums I will explain on day after tomorrow, okay? The first sum is 8345 8945 8562 8349. So first I am going to arrange these numbers in ascending order. So ascending order means what? Ascending order means arranging the numbers from small to big. Now I have to check which number is small among the given numbers. The first number is 8345. The second number, in thousands place all these numbers are having 8. Let us see the hundreds place. In the hundreds place, the first number is having 3, the second number is having 9, the third number is having 5, and the last number is having 3. So these two numbers are having same numbers in their hundreds place. These two numbers are having 3 in their hundreds place. So this number is having 4 in its tens place, and this number is also having 4 in its tens place. In its ones place, this number is having 5 and this number is having 9. You know that 5 is smaller than 9. So first you have to arrange 8345 first. Did you understand, children? I am given 4 numbers. In the 4 numbers, all these numbers are having 8 in their thousands place. So I am going to the next place, which is the hundreds place. In hundreds place, the first number and the last number are having 3. So first I am going to compare these two numbers. So in the hundreds place, both these numbers are having 3, and in their tens place, both the numbers are having 4. So in the tens place, since they both the numbers are having same numbers, I am going to the next place, which is the ones place. In ones place, here it is 5 and here it is 9. You know that 5 is smaller than 9. So I am arranging 8345 first. After that, I am going to arrange 8349. Okay. So after arranging these two numbers, two more numbers are left. Here in 89,000. Here the second number is 8945 and the third number is 8562. In the hundreds place, this number is having 9 and this number is having 5. You know that 5 is smaller than 9. So you have to arrange 8562 in the third place and 8945 at the last. So did you understand, students? What I have done, I am given 4 numbers and I have arranged these numbers in ascending order, which is from small to big. So first I have checked the thousands places of all these numbers. All these numbers are having 8 in their thousands place. So I have gone to the next place. In the next place, this number is having 3 and the last number is also having 3 in their hundreds place. First I am going to compare these two numbers. So in this number, the tens place is having 4 and this number also it is having 4. So I have gone to the next place, which is ones place. In the ones place, this number is having 5 and this number is having 9. You know that 5 is smaller than 9. So I am going to arrange 8345 in the first place because it is the smallest number among all. After that, I have arranged 8349 because it is the second smallest number. So after that, I have arranged 8562 because it is having 5 in its hundreds place and this number is having 9 in its hundreds place. You know that 5 is smaller than 9. So I have arranged this number in the third place and this number in the last place. This is called the ascending order. Now I am going to write the descending order. You know that descending order means arranging numbers from big to small. So among all these numbers, 8945 is the biggest number. So I am going to write it at the first place. In the second place, we have to write 8562. And in the third place, we have to write 8349. And in the fourth place, we have to write 8345. Did you observe that I have just reversed all these numbers? Ascending order means arranging the numbers from small to big. And descending order means arranging the numbers from big to small. So simply I have written all these numbers in the reverse. Isn't it? First I wrote 8945. Next I wrote 8562. Next I wrote 8349. And at the last I wrote the 8345. If we reverse the ascending order, we will get the descending order. So simply by reversing these numbers, you can write the descending order for the given numbers. Okay, children, I have explained only first sum in the 8th question. Remaining sums, I will explain them on the day after tomorrow. Okay, for today, bye. Okay.